Welcome back to another brand new episode of Michael's Quarter. We have a bit of a fun one for you today. Today we're going to be listing off things that I wish I knew before I bought. Now, chances are there's a couple things on this list that you already know, but hopefully we're going to bring a couple of new items to light and save you a lot of headaches down the road. Okay, so we have a list of roughly about 11-ish things we're gonna cover today. And again, hopefully we've got some new tips for you that will save you a lot of headaches. So number one, you can shop around for lenders, and you should. Now this may seem pretty obvious, but it is remarkable how many people I come across that are only going to their original bank. And while the bank may have a good rate, unless you shop around, you have no idea if it's the best rate or not. Okay. Plus, of course, this ties in with getting pre-approved before you start shopping. Sellers will often ask if you're pre-approved, and if you're not, they may not even bother negotiating the deal with you. And nothing is worse than missing out on the one because you weren't prepared. Okay. Number two, be picky when choosing your agent. Do not be afraid to ask any and all questions, no matter how silly you think they are. This will likely be one of the biggest purchases or the biggest purchase of your life so far, and this is not the time to be bashful. So make sure they know their stuff, run them through the ringer, give them the 20 questions, and if you're not satisfied, move on to somebody else. All right, number three, search for a house that fits your life, okay? But beware, you will change your mind and you will almost certainly compromise, okay? It's almost unheard of that you're gonna be able to get everything you were looking for in the price point that you're shopping in. So be prepared for that. Number four, a picture says 1,000 words, but that doesn't always mean they're truthful. Camera tech has come a long way and certain types of lenses can create the illusion that the room is quite a bit bigger than it really is. And a cool pro tip that I tell my clients is look for the hidden gems with horrible photographs. Just because the seller hired someone who doesn't understand the value of proper marketing and took photos with their cell phone doesn't mean the home itself is awful. All right, number five, turn on all 5 of your senses. Well, okay, you can probably skip the taste one. It'd probably be a little weird if you're running around trying to taste the home you're about to buy. But the other four, sight, hearing, touch, and smell, can and should help play a role in going through the house. Note down any and all concerns that you might have and ask someone with your trust and the knowledge to answer competently. Number six, it's really easy to get caught up in the superficial. Try to look past paint colors and things that can be easily changed or fixed, and try to look for the potential of the home. And if you are looking for that premium home, that freshly renovated gem in an exclusive neighborhood, please understand you will pay quite a bit more for that. So if that's what you're looking for, then quite possibly you're gonna have to compromise on the size of the home, size of the lot or location to get those features. So again, this is kind of where a little pre-planning comes in handy here. Number seven, use skilled professionals. Just because they are your friend or your cousin or your uncle or whatever does not mean they are the right one for you. Just because they have a license does not mean that they are skilled. And there are countless stories of regret by those that ignored that rule. Number eight, don't get pressured. And now obviously this applies to, pushy representatives, but it also applies to family, friends, co-workers. You're gonna quickly find out as soon as you start telling people you're shopping for a home, everyone has an opinion, and chances are they do mean well, but it won't be them living in and paying for the home at the end of the day. So don't get pressured, trust your gut, go with that. Number nine, the home inspection is unbelievably important. Pay for a great home inspector and they will be worth it. Do not cheap out on this step. And don't be surprised when they find problems, because they will always find problems no matter what. So be prepared and decide on how to address the important ones. A skilled realtor is gonna help walk you through your options and through any renegotiation that may happen as a result of that. Number 10, you can actually do all sorts of repairs and improvements yourself. No professionals required. I know that's in direct contradiction to what we were just talking about using skilled trades. However, thanks to the wonderful world of the internet, there are millions of how-to articles and videos to help walk you through many basic and some not so basic repairs around the home. But know your limits. Fixing it yourself can often be cheaper as long as you don't make the problem worse. And finally, number 11, make sure you budget and plan for costs. There are transition costs are a very common thing, and it's surprisingly uncommon to actually have your possession dates lined up perfectly between selling your old home or giving up the lease on your property and moving into your new home. There's always a gap or a crossover, almost certainly. So be prepared to have to cover an extra mortgage payment or rent payment in case you can't get them lined up perfectly. And if you are selling your existing home, be sure to look at bridge financing with your lender. If you can't afford it, giving yourself an extra week to make the move takes a ton of stress out of the whole process. And a couple other costs you want to consider and be prepared for: legal fees, home inspector, moving through. Sometimes there's charges for moving utilities, forwarding mail, things like that. So make sure you do have a little bit of a nest egg left. Okay, so that wraps up our list here, and I hope you found that informative. This was a fun episode to record and put together, and hopefully it will save you from making a critical mistake. So, was there anything I missed? Let me know in the comments down below, and if you enjoyed this video, please be sure to leave a like. It really helps us out. I hope you have an awesome rest of your day, and I will see you next time.